Yes, hello. Welcome to the Witness Without Identity. So this is what's going on, guys. I want to talk about Prince Harry, Meghan Markle, guys. Prince Harry had an interview, and he's bringing the Queen and the royal family, and many people are not totally comfortable with that, and we understand that. So there's a video that came out, and where the lady had an interview with this is on ABC News Prime, and they were explaining that like the royal commentator Emily Andrew, she was discussing the recent Prince Harry podcast interview and how he was and basically how the interview was received by the royal family. Basically, Prince Harry is telling the truth, but I understand what some people are saying. They're saying that this is not the right time to do this because the queen just came from like the death of her husband. But you know what people don't understand? I've seen that happen in many families. People think the grandkids are very close to their grandparents. I personally don't think so. I do not think so. I look at grandkids. I look at like nephews, brothers and sisters, all those people. Like they're not that close. The only person that is close to you is your mother and your father, and that's it. And so they basically, many people are complaining and they're saying why Prince Harry doesn't care about his grandmother. She's just agonizing about her husband's death. And no, I don't think so. Like, he wants to live his life. And he's saying what he gotta say. But I would like to bring you guys the podcast when I have a chance so we can talk about it more. Okay, thank you guys. You know, this is a Witness Without Identity where we talk about issues, but we're trying to be neutral. We're trying to witness it without any identity, without any identifying of anything. All right, thank you. Watch the clip and let me know what you think.
Royal commentator Emily Andrews. Emily, thank you for taking time to be with us tonight. We know what's maybe most noteworthy about this interview is the timing of it. It comes on the heels of that bombshell Oprah interview. Then, of course, the royal family lost Prince Philip, Harry's grandfather. And any death in the family can be a sensitive time. What do you think Harry is hoping to accomplish by speaking out now about the trauma he experienced growing up?
Well, Trevor, you make an excellent point there. I mean, I don't think the timing could have been worse, really. After the death of the Duke of Edinburgh, the Queen still very much grieving her husband, and indeed Prince Charles grieving his father. I think whatever age you are, to lose a parent is very traumatic. Harry actually was talking to Dax Shepherd in this very popular podcast to promote his mental health series with Oprah Winfrey, which premieres later this month. And that's the reason why he went on the podcast, obviously, to talk about mental health. You know, he's a great mental health ambassador. He's had therapy himself. It's something he feels passionately about. And actually, you know, I listened to all of the 90 minutes and I thought it was on the whole pretty good. It's just that Harry kind of couldn't help himself but drag his kind of father and his grandparents into the conversation with him. And it was that sort of en passant criticism that has made headlines around the world.
It is very hard to separate those two when your entire family is under that microscope. And I do want to drill down on what Harry was trying to express, because I don't think he was necessarily specifically trying to call out his father, his grandfather. He was more talking about what it means to grow up with that royal spotlight. He said it was like he was in a zoo. And you can understand the frustration of being born into something like that without really choosing it. Can you elaborate for us what you think he meant when he was saying about that job specifically, "Look at what it did to my mom"?
Yes, and I thought it was really interesting that he referenced his mother a lot in the interview. I mean, he several times said, you know, I wanted to honor my mother, and I'm, you know, as Princess Diana's son, as one of Princess Diana's sons. He said that a couple of times. Now, maybe a cynic might say, well, obviously, Princess Diana, hugely famous in the US. Was he sort of doing that for the US market? No, I don't think so. I think he genuinely does want to make his mum proud. What was he hoping to achieve? Well, it's really interesting, actually, that you should ask that, because I think Prince Harry genuinely wants to help people. You know, whenever I've chatted to him, been on engagements with him, danced with him at a children's home in Brazil, you know, been with him in South Africa, that's what drives him, his wish to make the world a better place and to help every single person he meets. he was very open in the podcast. He said that actually it's quite a selfish thing because he's discovered that helping other people helps him. But he said, you know what? It's fine to acknowledge that as long as outcome is positive, good, then that surely can only be a good thing. But I think what else he was trying to do by talking about his mental health and talking about his mental health struggles was that if it helps one person who was listening, then that can only be a good thing. And I suppose he referenced his upbringing and that sense of being in the Truman Show and being in a zoo or like a cage animal was in reference to the fact that on the face of it, people might look at his life and think, wow, you're a prince, you live in a palace, it's amazing. But in effect, he said, it was a gilded cage and I was unhappy for a very long time.
Mm-hmm. And he was, of course, sharing a story, as we all have the right to do, but when you're in his position, it's going to make some waves, especially when he is naming his father, Prince Charles, and others specifically. It's a family that people can be very protective of. How do you think people are reacting to what could be maybe taken as direct criticism of the family?
Well, I think the real problem here is the criticism of the Queen. I don't think Harry meant it, and I think that's the problem. I think Harry doesn't think often, or maybe he overthinks, but he kind of only really sees it through the prism of himself. You don't criticize the Queen. She's 95. She's bombproof. You know, here in the UK, she's like a kind of demigod. I mean, she is, frankly, around the world. She's head of the Commonwealth. She's incredibly popular. And as you say, it's the timing. She's just lost her husband of 73 years. It's a really, really difficult time for her. And so I think it was Harry not thinking, but really, at this of all times, he should have been about his grandmother in particular. I think at this particular point in time, it perhaps wasn't particularly advisable to sort of strike out against the Queen and Prince Charles, even though he did it, in my opinion, in an accidental way. He should have thought more about what he was trying to say, because at this particular point in time, I think the royal family are wanting to mend relations with Harry and Meghan. They understand that they had things they wanted to get off their chest once they got over the initial anger and the shock of how frank they were on Oprah. I think they wanted to sort of draw a line under it and move on. And Harry then kind of reopening it with these comments on the podcast is not going to help matters.
Well, if nothing else, with this family, you can bet.